Thank you. Kembo, Kembo, Natatan, Zambi, Yamazulu, King, Fumu Kakuisa, Zambi Mawesha, Zambi Yakubenisha, Bayete, Betwabu, Saubona, Dumalang, Luvuvamu, Yala! For those who don't know, that means peace be unto you, and Yala reign, or what we call Judah, number four. I want to say greetings, welcome to all of the Banabetu scattered across the earth, to all the non-Bantus who are joining with us, to all those who are here learning, with your greetings. I thank you once again for tuning in to this channel. A lot has transpired just even in this last week. And I hope that I'm going to be re-emphasizing the idea of the reprobate mind versus the sober mind. Tatan Zambi really feels that this is something that needs to be hammered down, because especially with certain things that have come into light, this is something that's very important to know. Now, I'm very certain, as it has been asked of me, as to my view on certain things that have now come to light. What I will say is something from a wise brother that I've talked to, especially growing up in America. There's one thing that we always knew when we used to get in trouble with mom and dad, or something was going on where you have siblings and siblings talking about stuff. And the one thing that we understood was there was one story with one person's side, the other story with another person's side, and then there was the right side, the correct story. And so what I would encourage people to do is to seek Tatan Zambi and Pungu Tulendo about all things. Have the Mwanda Velela, the Mwanda Semi, to give the revelation if you are truly connected, because there are those who think they are connected to the Moyo Mpeve, and they're not, but they do a very good job of fronting in that regard, or faking it till they make it. Remember, I said that not everybody who says they have been forgiven of their sins really has been. Because this is all about YouTube. And we know with YouTube, there's a whole lot of actors out here. And it's about the spirit of discernment. I know that I'm not perfect in any way. I truly believe in the scripture where Isaiah said, let him or she, he or she, because we know they always take the women out of our original scriptures. But those who have no sin in them, let them cast the first stone. I don't know the circumstances of anything as much. I know different bits and pieces about certain things, but I do know that Tatanzambi gave me a staunch warning for those who are masquerading and not being truthful about things, and also those who are actually walking in righteousness, that you need to be prepared for whatever changes are coming. But that's where I'm going to leave it at, because like I said, this channel is not about me doing anything other than being a watchman and to do my due diligence to warn people of my mandate, which is to expose the lies of the devil, which is why he's so much of an attacking force against me and his minions. And to continue to help people grow in spirit and in truth to the truth of the Most High, to the best of their ability, and to learn how to communicate better and be in a relationship with him. All right, so before I go any further, Manakumase, Mwana, Mwana Velela, Kimbo Kimbo Tatanzami Amazulu King Fumo Kakuisa. Tatanzambi, Fungu Father, I ask that this message that I will be bringing once again will be protected by the Maliki Makongo, that no interference will be done by those who seek harm to destroy this message, and that Tatanzami, this will be something that people can take and reflect upon and grow upon. I want to give honor to Kuswa Kongo, Yesaya, Yesu, Yesui. I want to give honor to the Maliki Mako, to the Mwanevelela. I want to give honor to the righteous 24 elders, the righteous of Isolele ancestors, the Maliki Makongo as well, if I didn't say so, all the way down to the ancestors of Adama. I want to give honor to those who are doing the Most High's work. You know, I don't say the Tokwis and the Kimbanguis enough, and others who are also doing this work in other realms. Those who have continued to work hard to help our people wake up and to do what's righteous. And again, you know, soon and very soon, the agents, and I've seen, you know, there's been revelations given, the agents are about to go away real soon. And the people are going to start to really see, and you'll then know who's who. And it'll make it a lot easier for you to not have to sit there and guess. Because many more are coming. They don't know. They've tried to speculate. The Most High is very secretive. He doesn't always reveal things to everybody just because they want to know things. You have to be patient with Tatanzami because everything gets revealed in his time, because he is playing, he is battling against those who are doing wickedness and who hate him. And he always will be victorious. He always win the battle in the war. But you have to remember that we will endure sufferings in the process because of their hatred. I'm in the Kikongo Bible. I know it's not the pure Kikongo, but I'm going to read from Romans again, a little bit, Romans 1:18 once again in the Kikongo. And we're going to talk about, once again, the reprobate mind, because this is something that is very crucial. Why? Is because, as we know how I say, a man thinketh, so is he. Isaiah talks about that. Also, there are people who think that they are what they think they are, and their way of is death. Proverbs, we'll talk about that. And to be really sober-minded has to include spiritual-minded. And there are those who think that in the spiritual mind we're talking about is not just any type of spiritual minded. It has to be the righteous spiritual mind of Tatanzami or Kongo Yahweh. So there's people who have to understand, you know, to discern something, you must have the proper frequency, discernment, spirituality. Okay, this is verse 18, Romans chapter 1, if you want to follow along. Kadian Ganzi in Zambi, Zizaku, Swangatuka, Muzulumu, Udimbuku, Luanonso, Sono, Luabantu, Yemukandwa, Kwalungungu, Basimbi Dalanga Kedika, Mu Kondwa, Kwalungungu. Give me, I'm stuffed up a little bit today. Kadi Mayazekene Nzambi Mamonekene Nu Yao Kadi Nzambi Baba Monikisina Mo Kadi Mena Yandi Malembwa Monika Alulendo Luandi Luamvu Yamvun Yakinzambi Kiandi Kiamvu Yamvu Bimonwanga tuka mo nsemono ausa buviswanga kwa mavanga kabidi baka mpengo monoko mo mpengo mokono karibu bazaya nzambi ka bakembila bonso nzambi ko ka batonda kwa yandi kaikansi Batumpalala mabanza mao ntima mao mabuzengi mayika tombe. Buka vivovila vo bandwenga bayikidi buzengi bazekula mkembo nzambi Umbolo, Fukila, Mufanana, Kifani, Kiamuntu, Afukilanga, Ye, Kiazinuni, Ye, Kiabulu, Biamumalu, Mai, Ye, Kiabulu, Biazanzalanga. Okay, and I wanted to add another scripture. Second. What did I want? James 1:18. Yaounde. Like I said, we're not like what Kimbangu says. We're not throwing out the book, even though it's all tainted. There are ways to learn from it. You know, contrary to what Christians think, they think they have all the knowledge in the Bible, and it doesn't. It even says itself, it's not. It can't all be in there. So they want to be, you know, thinking that this is right. I'm going to talk about something that Toko once again talked about. I did talk about this in the past. And I want to talk about the salvation of Tatanzambi to get clarity to help people understand that this is the concept of the definition of a person with a reprobate mind. So when I go back to Romans, sorry, excuse me, let me hide this. All right, so 1 second, excuse me. All right. Many people. And this is something that was written by, you know, Yaya, he put this together by Mayamona. He said, many people, this is the Child of Revelation 12, for those who choose to believe it, if you don't, that's totally up to you. But I know, and I've experienced some things that verify that we are in, that I am indeed correct. Because what I see, what's happening to our awakening now, is that those who choose to push the idea of Simon Toko versus those who choose to deny it are the ones that are catching the most scrutiny. And that should tell you something. Many people have that mania that I can do whatever I want because I will be saved by grace. And if you look at a lot of the evangelical churches, even now, you look at a lot of the Christian faith-based religions, even now, non-denominational, even Baptists and stuff like this. This is something that is actually something that they really believe. Or else they wouldn't have that concept where they say, I'm going to sit on Saturday and go to church on Sunday. Okay? This is something that people actually say. You have to understand that people don't realize, and this is what the Most High says when it's called the concept of a reprobate mind says, oh, I'm covered by the grace. So if I sin, I'm already covered because I have Jesus Christ, or I have the blood of Jesus, and all these different things that they say that goes along with that. But what they fail to realize is, no, the concept of turning away from sin means the intent is to not repeat the act. But if for whatever reason you should incidentally repeat the act, Yesiah is there to help you. Okay? Well, it's not the intent that you're going to continue to still do whatever you want or have the act that you're doing, saying that, oh, but I have Jesus Christ and I have this and I have, you know, I have the love of God and I know him. Okay, we know Tatanzambi, we know the real name Tatanzambi, Yahweh Congo, Yesaya, Yesu, Christu. You know, because they've changed a lot of things. People don't want to believe that. That's their choice. But the concept is that the reprobate mind says exactly what verse 28 says. And even as they did not like to retain Tatanzambi in their knowledge, the Most High in their knowledge, gave them over to reprobate mind to do the things which are not convenient. Meaning, you're going to do whatever you want. Or things that are going to be like, whoa, you know, I really didn't want to have to do that, but okay. Why? Because he's saying, first of all, you think the creation should go above the creator when you're talking about his son. And he has more than one son. This is the whole concept. Now he have these son and then just others. This is how people have been deceived. And, okay. The mindset is you worship what you think people have taught you is right. So when you have this whole mindset, I know what I'm doing, I know it's right, blah, 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 and you haven't verified it with him, the reprobate mind stays. Okay? You go listen to your pastor on Sunday. You just listened to him preach. You didn't ask the Most High not one time. Did everything he say line up with the truth? Did it? Am I even in the right church to begin with? Do you even ask that question? You just assume that because a person says the word Christian, they're all on the same page. Lie. Okay. Baklistu, the purest form of the belief of the Messiah and all the things that he did, is way bigger than what you would hear on Sunday or Saturday if you're a Seventh-day Adventist. I mean, or whatever you think you believe in. The minute you start to think that everything that you believe about the Messiah is accurate and true to what you've been told, already sets you up for the reprobate mind, because the Most High is always the final one you should always be checking to validate what you hear. Because he has already said it in the scriptures. I shall send thee a strong delusion when you believe a lie. He can send false spirits to make you believe whatever you want. If you choose to think that your mindset is good enough to understand things. This is why the world sits where it sits, because you can't tell people nothing. You can't tell anybody anything about, they know it. Oh, I know Jesus, I know God, I know this. Then why? Why do you still do these things? Being filled with unrighteousness, they fornicate. Wickedness, and when he's talking about wickedness, he means you go and you do the little things in the corner that you shouldn't be doing. Trust me, I can attest to that. I think the Most High, you know, he's been doing a great work. Covetousness, you always want, hey, I like that car, that nice car you got. I see Christians that like cars more than the Most High. Pay more attention to that. Trust me, I'm guilty as charged because I love to keep my car clean. Maliciousness, full of envy. Envy means is that you say, man, I know I'm better than you. Or what's that? Those, you know, black people start talking about what people wear. Always in church. Whispers, man, she got a weave on. Okay. This is the problem here. Despiteful, proud. Oh, yeah, man. I got that nice promotion. I'm now the big dog on the block. I got all these people underneath me, bam, 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 proud. In a world that doesn't even care about you, it's all set up to make you fail in the kingdom. The Most High has nothing to do with this kingdom that you claim he belongs to, where he even, the devil told Uzziah, I was given, and the Most High gave him this access. But Satan don't have the power. The Most High gave it over. You have to be the one to discern, to take it back. But see, with this captivity we've been placed into, the world is in so much blindness. Because the salvation comes through his people that know the real Messiah. John 4, 22. Yoani. So the Most High is saying, when you have a reprobate mindset, a concept that you think you know, okay, or you have put images ahead of him, you're going to cause yourself to dishonor yourself, because he's telling you you're going to dishonor your own body. Where he says, wherefore have not been given to others to the lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves. Now, here's the thing. If a person you're talking to has not been removed of their sober mind, there's no discernment with this person. This is one of the reasons I'm even going to, because I struggle with this too, and the Most High really helped me through it, and our family's getting better. And this is something that all of us need to work on, this whole concept of being double-minded, because you are unstable when you're double-minded. You really are. Can you repent of it and be clean for a while and then mess up sometimes? You can. But the hope is that you don't fall back into that mindset. Because double-mindedness means you cannot serve the Most High in a way that is going to lead people to the real truth. This is why when the Most High loves you and chastens you, you start becoming double-minded, he's going to pop you and you're going to get humbled. He's going to pop you and you're going to get humbled. If he is indeed, if you're anointed and he loves you, you are going to get hit. And he says, you need to stop. If he has no love for you whatsoever, keep going. Do what you want. And you know there's people that's like that. You know, you can tell in this world who the Most High really walks with and whom he doesn't. And who's masquerading and who's for real. Especially now you know more about the truth. He had his back turned for quite a while. But people have been masquerading like he's talking to them. Now he's talked to the embassy to help progress us because they still kept watched over us. But it's not to the level that it is now. It's a whole nother story now. This is why they're really freaking out, because his face is turned back around to help his people grow. And this is why you're getting so much tension and also so much attempts to stop us. You know, they come after you, your family, your friends, you know, all these people. The devil uses whatever means necessary, because as we continue to exploit, you have to understand, we've been on the bottom for so long. And I don't care what, you might find a few of them, like, you know, the military makes it happen, but you don't see too many white people that like being told what to do by black people, period. And to find out that now this is something that's going to become the reality of many nations here pretty soon. Not to say there's not white Bantus amongst us, because we have the albino and it changes the color. Most of us are going to fix a lot of this stuff. But it's not something that sits well with those who have been in a position of a superiority to others to be told you're going to the bottom. Like Simone Kimbangu said. So the understanding is, and then of course you have those of us who are comfortable with the way the society is, that they are willing to go against us because they don't want to change. Or they think that we're wrong, or they think that they got it made, and so they will play this role. Or they're so dumbed down that they're being manipulated and don't even know it, because we got a lot of people like that here in America and other places. They know that you have lack of intelligence, so they use that to their advantage to go against those who are trying to push the truth. They know the frequencies that you operate under when you're at different levels of spirituality. Okay? So this is key to the manipulation concept for those who don't want to be exposed, or those who are angry because they're being exposed, because their lies are coming to the fruition, because they know they've been played, but still don't like the fact that we're talking about it. Okay? Many, many pastors right now are angry. Why? Because it's a racket that they have been doing. Using false spirituality to convince people that they have the power when they can't do a thing but pray. Can't actually manifest anything. Can't talk to any angels to do a thing. Can't actually do what Messiah says and more. So it exposes the world to know that there was a man and other people that did it, and nobody knew who they were. And this poses a threat to those who make the money, like the Vatican and everybody else, Islam, Judaism. They making all this money off of their lies. So anybody that's affecting that is a threat. The millionaires, the billionaires, anybody who's getting questioned on the ideology that they were saying, oh, we're getting blessed by the Creator. We're getting all, and the Most High said, that's a lie. This is baloney. They are doing their due diligence to work with the devil in secret, and he's masquerading to make it look like this is true. This is why you stay in that reprobate mindset, thinking that these people, oh yeah, the minute they say, oh, I love God and this and this and that, you hit it right away, because you're under a spell. They spellbound every day. And to have the people realize it, it's like, whoa, wait a minute. You could be right. You're onto something there. Because how can there be such inconsistencies in the wealth factor when it comes to the Holy Spirit, the Manavilana, and the Most High? That people who say they love God and love Jesus are so broke, while others of people are just pouring with money. How can that be? Okay. And that's why he's saying, okay, but let's not forget that if God, or Tatanzambi, Yahweh Congo, saved everyone by grace, there would be no lake of fire for the wicked. That's what he's saying. This is the game that these pastors are playing with. You can't, if everybody's saved by grace through faith, then what's the point of the lake of fire? This is the whole concept of being reprobate minded. That you believe what they're telling you is to be true. Let's go to Yaounde James. Here we go. Yaounde, a servant of Tatanzambi in the Fumo Yisaya Congo, used to please through the 12 tribes scattered abroad. Greetings. So they scattered abroad. Everybody don't realize we've been scattered. Even when we were brought together in the kingdom of Congo, we still had people scattered. My brethren, this is the Makanda family, Count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. So here's what you got to understand. And this is hard for me at times. When the devil is really socking it to you, you still got to have joy. When you're really dealing with some hard, hard things that you're facing, you still got to be in joy. Why? Because the minute you want to go negative, the devil's sitting right there. Oh, I got that power right there. I got the controls right here. Now you're leaning on my territory. And this is what they have been, this is why they want Bantu people and Black people and all of us constantly bickering, constantly dealing with strife, constantly doing with all this. And see, nobody paid attention. This is the reason why we were singing in the fields, picking the cotton, because we understood this is what we were taught by Yaoundé, James, count it all joy. So we had to be the people. You don't see anybody else singing when they're getting beat up other than we did. Even when we were sitting in jail, when we were building on the chain gang, singing, okay? Why? Count it all joy. Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. So every time the devil comes to try you and you conquer that, you have good developing the patience. To deal with things. This is allows you to come slow to anger. You don't let yourself get bent out of shape too fast. And you allow yourself to listen. The biggest thing about patience, this is why when I watch people talk, just like I watch those videos, I watch other people too. And I see what people have said. Because there have been things, some things that have been said this week that Kuso Kongo says is a flat out lie. Okay. And I'm going to get to why he had to open the heaven to the other people who had come before him. So he had to be crucified somehow. Is it for everybody? No. But the three strikes and you're out, people, I told you that is the mockery. But I'm telling you, people need to realize when you get information from elders, you better vet it through the Most High to make sure that it's not mixed. Because some of the stuff they're telling you is to actually cause you more problems before you start saying things. Because they're Pharisees too. They don't always believe that Uzziah did what he did. So there's Bantu Pharisees that still exist today, despite you got, it's not just the Ashkenazis and the Christians who do condemnation that act like Pharisees. Our own people and elders still do it. They don't always believe what Uzziah did. There's always this question, did it really happen that way? You don't understand. That's why you got to go to the source. Kuso Kongo will tell you. This is what happened. This will not happen. It didn't happen. When you have that relationship. Knowing this, but let patience have her perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. This is the whole concept of how the ridiculous concept of a capitalist society is completely opposite of the mindset that many Christians have with this scripture. When you have patience and you're working perfectly to be the work of doing things the right way, you don't need many things. The Most High at that point provides you everything, and I do mean everything, that you need. The problem that comes into the picture is want. Want is carnal. Want is where you start leaning into the carnal. Need is where you start leaning into the spiritual. There's a difference. This is why they have programmed you like a 12-year-old to want things. Oh, I gotta have this. Oh, I gotta have that. Because Bantu people are breaking the law. Nobody else, if you don't have, the people who weren't born with the law in their heart, they're not doing nothing. They're just doing what they're supposed to be doing. The ones that have the law, we are the ones messing up. And the power gets stolen from us. And they charge themselves with our wicked ways. Because the demons are right there to suck it all up. That's what they do. If any of you lack wisdom, this is why it's always, I tell you, man, when you have the correct connection with the Creator, not the one, because I did a video, you know, I was going to put up a matter of fact, I wanted to put it the picture, but y'all know this, the picture of Nimrod. I know he's here around me somewhere. People don't even know that's who they're praying to. That Anunnaki, go look up Anunnaki Nimrod. That picture, that demon, that's who you're praying to when you say God, Lord, all these different things. If you don't know the difference, it's going to mess you up. People don't even know this. That's Allah. That's the Yahweh to the liars. Is him. The Tatanza Mimpungu Akongo Yahweh requires you to be connected to the spirit of Congo. The Moyan Pebe, the spirit of Congo is truth. So the wisdom has to first, in order to get wisdom, you first got to be dialing the right phone number. That's the first part. The next part is you have to ask him. Ask. Seek, find. That's where it starts. As a child, you have no knowledge. He has all the knowledge. Okay? That giveth to all men, liberally. So he's not going to be the kind of creator that's going to be just like, oh, I'll get you a little piece here. I catch you a little piece there. Oh, no, he gives you an abundance. He loves you. So why would he hold back? And abraded is not, meaning he don't hold back nothing. Here, take it. As much as you can handle, because he knows that everybody can handle it all. And it should be given to him or her. But let him ask in faith, meaning don't go and say, well, I might ask this question, but the Most High might not be able to. No, don't do that. When you go to talk to him, have the faith that he is going to do it no matter what. It's already done. Not wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea. Okay? With the wind and toss. For let not that man, Muntu, that he was to receive anything of the Most High. So if you're tossing to and fro, he might give it to me, he might not, he might believe me, he might not, then he's like, get away, what are you here for? Do you believe it or not? Are you in the way or are you not in the way? You can't be in the middle. Do you believe in Tatanzambi and Pumutadeno Akongo 100% that he can do it for you, or do you not? Don't be in between. Because he's like, then what you ask for if you didn't believe it? That's crucial to when we talk about people who are reprobate minded and now the double minded person. The double-minded person is the one that wavers in their faith with the Most High. The one that focuses on things contrary to what the Most High wants while still trying to be with the Most High. And believe me, I'm guilty as charged when it comes to stuff like that because I am still a work in progress myself. And we have to always remember, we're still learning this. We're still learning this because the information is flowing from the knowledge that was taken away. So nobody can say, I got it right, you got it wrong, this and this and that. Because the Most High knows. He does things differently than you do when it comes to how he decides who gets what. How, what secrets are brought out, who he tells what things. You see, you got elders out here. And I'm telling you, Kuswa Kongo is lit up because you're not paying attention to where thieves are. You open in the sheep gate to the wolves because you're not focusing, you're not paying attention. And he takes that seriously when you're supposed to be the shepherd and you're acting like the hireling and you're letting people have a peace that they should have no business having. Don't think he doesn't take it seriously. That's why I have to make sure that my ministry is more solid every day, more sound every day, more focused every day, to make sure people aren't getting brought to the wolves. Have I gotten it wrong because I've been duped sometimes? Yes, but there's a difference between not knowing and doing it on purpose. Big time. Because that lion, you don't want to see the lion come out of Kuswa Kongo. Believe that. Believe you me, you don't want to see the lion come out of Kuswa Kongo on you. Because when you have that reprobate mind and you're not sober, like Kepa said, Peter, then you have opened the door to wickedness that shouldn't be there. So you cannot be the, I myself have learned, I cannot be double-minded. I can't be wavering. My focus can't be distracted. And the Most High has really started to show me the comprehension of that. Because why? Because then you cannot see the enemy clearly. You cannot see his works. You cannot see how he's prowling. You cannot see how he's attacking you when you're distracted. This is where Christians have been deceived. Their own pastor is preying on them, and they can't see it. They have a system that they're a part of today, right now, okay? And the problem is they are being distracted and they cannot see. Okay? This is one of the reasons why they hate what we're doing to them, because we're exposing the wolves. The wolves don't, you have to remember, wolves don't want to be seen when they're hunting. They stay stealthy. When they're chasing the deer, they're chasing the pack that's going after something, they go down and they're trying to be remain hidden, like the lion too. The lion doesn't want to be hit, seen, okay? Once you give up his hiding spot, the jig is up. I can't hunt no more. This is what we're trying to help Bantu people understand. When you're reprobate minded, you can't see the wolf. You can't see the lion. You can't see any predator. You can't discern anything. When you have reprobate minded, double-mindedness in you. This is why those of us who stay sober-minded will always be under attack. And will be always, they're always looking for the way in. because we standing there. No. I see you over there. I see what you're doing, because the monitor's working too. The Moyen Pevis, I see it. Okay, I got you over here. Okay. It becomes harder to hide yourself when you focus on Tatanzambi and the way he sees things, because he sees all of the predators coming after his people. And he will deal with them accordingly, like 2 Corinthians says. And you will get exposed. Let the brother of low degree rejoice in that he is exalted. So always honor those who are lower. Because but the rich, and that he is made low, okay? So this is about the rich folk. They think they're going to make it. Because as the flower of the grass, he shall pass away. So keep boasting in your riches and all your successes and everything. The Most High does not care. He wants the humility. He wants the humility. Let me make sure. Where it says here, Peter, verse 5, or chapter 5, verse, let's go right 6. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of Tatanzambi, that he will exalt you in due time. So don't look to exalt yourself. Let the Most High do it. Because then you've made it into the kingdom. If the Most High has exalted you, you have punched your ticket to the kingdom. You are there. You're going to be the one that he is going to brag. He will then let him do the bragging. Not you. Let him do the bragging. I don't want nobody bragging about me. Nobody. Telling, this guy, no. You let the Most High talk to them about me. Take them to the Most High and say, "Can Most High, tell me about this man." Let him be the one to either give you a good report, because it could be good and bad. If I'm doing something wrong, tell me. I want to know. This is important, especially with us who are fellowshipping as a makanda, as a family. Because we want to have each other's backs here, because we're trying to be unified. This is not about, I'm not going to keep my brother's back like Canaan, Alcana, Abel. Where's my brother at? I don't know. No, we are our brothers and sisters keepers in this truth, in this awakening. We are to watch each other's backs, because we are the shepherds of the sheep. And we will be held accountable for what we do. But you don't have to always put it out there, but let people know, hey, come on now. You got to take care of things a little bit better, tighten it up. Because they looking for us to fall. Because they don't want to see Banabetu of Bakongo people rise to the top. They don't want to see it. This is why they have agents and everybody out there pretending to be this and that and masquerading so well with dark magic that they're using. This is significant. Casting all your care, this is a big one for me. I got to remember this. Cast all your care upon him, upon the Most High, for he careth for you. Then it says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, Shatani, Azazel, whatever name he go by, as a roaring lion walketh about seeking whom he devours, and he can only devour you when you're reprobate-minded. When you're sober-minded to where the Most High has renewed your mind and you are now spiritual, not even your boss can pull a fast one over you. Wait a minute. None of your children can pull a fast one over you. Not even your spouse or whatever. You're going to catch them in something. Because the Most High has made you have clarity to how the devil is working against you. And you will get the alarm. Hey, you better deal with this. The devil's lurking. You got an issue coming out the perimeter. Something's going on out. You got some issues going on. You better deal with this. They want to catch you sleeping. Trust me, I know. I've seen it. These secret society people want to catch us sleeping. That's what they're looking for, because they know we hurting what they do, because they love that hidden hand garbage. They know they worship Nimrod. But they don't want you to know that. So to them, this is a slap in the face, because you giving up the secrets that they don't want people to know unless they give it to them. So they want the payback. So they're looking for you to slip. They're looking for you to mess up. They're looking for you to get that chink in the armor. They love that armor because they're the knights. Put on the full coverage of Tatan Zombie so they can't find. So they can't find the weakness. That they standing there, no matter what they do, no matter what they try, you standing up there, they have no ground to stand on. And they can't touch you, because they know you got the most high got your back. He's standing there like, please try it. This one time, try that. You don't even want to know how many people he's been damaging to get this truth where it's at. He knows everything that was going to happen even today. All the stuff that's been revealed, you think he didn't know from the foundation of earth that you were going to hear that? But he wants to see now, what are you going to do? Do you start wavering in your faith? And like, oh, I don't know about Simon Toko. I don't know about, oh, no. Or do you hold steadfast and say, you know what? These brothers need to get their act, these people need to get their act together, but I'm going to stay with the Most High and work into the truth and continue to grow. That's what is, because the devil wants to see you waver. Oh no, there's something wrong with this. Oh, I learned something bad. Oh, did you? Because I have always said with these type of things, it's all about timing. Why now? Why all of a sudden? Think about those type of things. What was going on that now all of a sudden this had to come out? Okay. But what I will say is this, and I'll close. You need to remove the reprobate mind to have the clarity of the removal. And when I say reprobate mind, it is the carnal mind of thinking. You must learn to remove carnality. Now, it can't be 100%, but you have to lean towards more spiritual than carnal, because we're living in Babylon. we know the Most High is going to clean it all up. And when he started to clean, and it's coming soon. Don't slip. It's coming sooner than you think. But let me say this again. Fools, let's go to Proverbs 14 to close it up. Fools make a mock at sin, but among them, the righteous, there is favor. So if you are righteous and walking in righteousness, the Most High will favor you, Bantu or non-Bantu, who's helping the Bantu. That's what Paul is really saying. Righteousness is righteousness, as long as you're not in this pagan mess. The heart knoweth his own bitterness. And this is something we've even learned in my own household. Your heart, once you know how bitter you are, you're going to realize how unforgiving you are too, and how unloving you are. Because the more bitterness you have, you can't be with the Most High. You have to let that bitterness go. And a stranger does not intermeddle with his joy. Because if you know your bitterness and you get rid of it, you're going to have joy. The house of the wicked shall be overthrown. That's for nation upon nation upon nation of this earth. He's telling you, the Most High will not let wickedness stand forever. It has to be overthrown, and the time is coming. But the tabernacle of the upright shall flourish, and your tabernacle starts with your body. This is where your fruits will start to grow as a person. When your reprobate mind is gone and you are sober and you walk in righteousness and you're not double-minded, and you're doing all these things that the Most High is pleasing to you, your fruits will start to flourish, and the world will see the difference from those who have been taking advantage of them to those who really care about them. And then it goes to here in verse 12, there is a way which seemeth right unto a person, a Benamuntu, a Benanzambi, a man or woman, that seems right, but the end thereof are the ways of death. So every person on this world, okay, has done something that they think this is right. There's nothing wrong with what I'm doing. In their own mind. Not checking with the Most High is dangerous. When you don't check what you're doing with Tatanzambi, it is dangerous. Because he's going to tell you at the end of the road, no, I was never cool with that. No, that was not, what are you talking about? That's wrong. Wait, my pastor, my mom and dad, my coach, they said this is the way we're supposed to live our life. Who when did you ask me? He's going to say that. When did you check with him? He said you ask him for the wisdom in all your ways. And that's how people get put in the pitfalls, to not even understand that they're not going anywhere because they're worshiping a dead God to begin with, because they didn't bother to ask. And they're in the wrong spirit, not having a clue. They believe everything they've been told here on this earth is validated for those who they value. But they didn't check with the Most High. Wait a minute. My dad said, help me understand this. My mom said, okay, so understand. And he even says, it goes further. Even in laughter, the heart is sorrowful. And the end of that mirth is heaviness. Because why? We see our people. We laughing, but we know it's sorrowful to see people suffer. Then it goes further. The backslider in his heart shall be filled in his own ways. So if you backslide and you think everything's cool, and most people sinning and don't know they backslide and they're sinning because they don't know the true concept of the Most High's laws and how Yesiah and how the Moan Nevelah, the Holy Spirit, will cause you to make sure you follow them according to the Spirit. This is why you got Pharisees out here doing feast days, once again, claiming they're attached to the Messiah and clueless to what really is supposed to be going on. You got Pharisees out there. You got Pharisees out there. All they had to do is put the Messiah's name on it, and you think everything's good. No, it's not. Okay? All right, family. I want to say Sambalolo Zola Kwingi, you know, Wizo Yabi Kongo Kutwala, and continue to understand something, that in order to discern anybody in any way, in any form, make sure you have been removed of that reprobate mind from the Most High and verify it. Because you, in order to do so, you must have gone to a real, real repentance to where he has renewed everything about you and validated that it's been cleaned. And don't just take people's word for it. Ask the Most High, did this person repent or not? Is this person trustworthy or not in what they're telling me? Always validate, okay? In a way that you have a Kongo Kutwala, Nsambulolo, Zola Kwingi, Ingita.